Hi, I'm Caroline from Doodles and Digits, and today we're going to be talking about numbers that look like this. Have you ever seen a number that looks like this? This is called a fraction greater than one, or some people call it an improper fraction. Whoa, whoa, whoa. There's something as a proper fraction? Yeah, some people call it improper fraction. Some people call it a fraction greater than one. It basically means a fraction that is greater than one whole. That's what you're gonna learn how to do by the end of this video. Let's get into it.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too. It's all here for you.
All right, so what is an improper fraction or a fraction greater than one? An improper fraction is where the numerator is greater than or equal to the denominator. So let's look at this example right here. What do you think we could know about an improper fraction if the numerator is greater or equal to the denominator? What do you think is hiding within that fraction? If the numerator is greater than the denominator, that means that there's actually at least one whole in that fraction, and that's why it's called improper.
How do we turn a fraction like this, an improper fraction, or a fraction greater than one, into a mixed number?
So, what we're going to do is we're going to turn this improper fraction into a mixed number. We can convert an improper fraction into a mixed number by taking out wholes. So let's look at this example problem right here. 24 fifths. We can think, how many groups of fifths can we take out of 24 fifths?
Let's look at a visual to help us. Models can be really helpful in this situation.
All right, so 24 fifths, we're going to take out one group of 5 fifths. 24 minus 5, 19 fifths. Now we're going to take out another group of 5 fifths. 19 fifths minus 5 fifths equals 14 fifths. 14 fifths minus 5 fifths equals 9 fifths. Finally, we're gonna take out our last group of 5 fifths. So if we have 24 fifths, it's actually the same as 4 wholes that we could take out and 4 fifths left over. We can actually check our work by going through and counting the fractions to make sure that 4 and 4 fifths is the same as 24 fifths. Is there another way that we can maybe go about solving this besides subtracting 5 fifths each time?
Now that we've looked at models to help us change an improper fraction into a mixed number, what other strategies are there? You can actually use a number line to help us figure out what mixed number is the same as an improper fraction or a fraction greater than one. Let's look at this one. Oh, number line.
This number line is broken down into fourths. Now we're going to jump 6 fourths. Now we can see that we went past one whole, so our whole number is going to be 1. Now we have to look at what fraction we went past that one whole. We went past one whole by 2 fourths. So our mixed number is 1 and 2 fourths.
All right, why would we ever need to use this? I always like to give the example of a pizza party. If you have a bunch of pizzas and everyone's eating different slices, and let's say you have 26 eighth pieces left over from your party, usually you're not gonna say, "Hey Bobby, I've got 26 eighth pieces left." You're gonna give him a mixed number. You're gonna say, "Hey, I have
3 1/4 pizzas."
Mixed numbers are a lot easier for us to process and digest and talk about in real life. Now that we've tried a few together and I've shown you a few different strategies, I want to see if you can solve a few on your own. Remember, you can use any of the strategies that we learned. Just find the one that works best for you.
7/3. And 1/3. All right, let's try another one. 13/8.
1 and 5 eighths. Eleven fourths. Two and three fourths. Look at all the jumps I made on the number line. 15 fifths. 3 holes. Did you notice we didn't have a fraction on this one? Because we had no fraction left over. All right, how'd you do? Did you get them all correct? Do you need other videos just like this one? Make sure you like and subscribe. We put new videos out every month. Bye.